Today I'm going to share with you the tool that I've got here on my desktop, which will allow you to improve the experience on Windows 10 or Windows 11 in a really easy way. Last week we took a look at WinPilot, which this is not a replacement. I believe that these two tools, WinPilot and Chris Titus' Tech Utility for Windows, do great job working together. If you haven't watched the WinPilot video, link will be down below. You will be amazed with the things that you can do with it with AI, and it will help us to enhance our experience. Now, for this video, I'm using the Asus TUF Gaming A16 right over here, which is a beast. If you haven't watched the review video down below as well, it has Windows 11 activated. But if you are with a computer with Windows 10 or 11 and you haven't activated, don't forget to check out KeysFan, where you can find budget official OEM keys at an affordable price. And with the coupon code that you can see on screen and down below on the video description, it will get a bit cheaper and you will have your Windows activated. So if you can't even change the desktop icons that you have on your computer, just activate it and get rid of that. Talking about desktop icons, I did record my Portuguese video just previously. Let me delete these right over here. I will show you how to install apps in a really fast way. Now, first of all, let's go to our browser. If you search for Chris Titus, you will find the Ultimate Windows Utility either on the website or on the GitHub. This is the GitHub page, and on the GitHub page you will have a link for the website as well. But the instructions are really easy. I'm going to share with you is just to copy a line of code, and basically that is it. If we go to the website, we have also this line of code right over here. We can copy and then paste on the PowerShell, I will show you. But there is one option, which is to downloads. If you want the .exe file to install, you can, but you will have to purchase and help out Chris Titus developing this project, which in my opinion, it's worth it. So this will depend to you. I'm going to share with you the free method, which is just basically go to the GitHub or web page and then copy where I did copy before, or you can copy right over here. That is it, copy it. And now we are going to close this and going to close this because your laptop will be like this or your desktop, and just search for PowerShell and press right click and run as administrator. Now right click and then it will paste automatically. In case it doesn't, just select paste, press enter, and bam, there we go. Chris Titus tools right over here. Now I'm going to leave this one in the background. Actually, we cannot close the PowerShell window. So what we have right over here, first of all, install and then tweaks and so on. Now install, you might say, okay, Robert, but if I want to install Chrome, I just go to my browser, download Chrome, and that is it. Yes, it's true, but you can just press a button and select install, and it will be installed as easy as this. Now I have got Firefox and I've got Chrome, but I can install Chromium and I can install any other browser or any other app. But the most interesting part is not that. It is divided by categories right over here, as we can see: communications, development, and some of these tools you are aware, some of them probably you aren't, and you should some of them. Like utilities, for example, 7-zip we have right over here. So if I want to install, I can just press it. I already did on my last video. But if I want to uninstall, for example, we can do that on this video. 7-zip, if I go right over here, it's here. And if I don't want to go to the app and whatnot, I can just select 7-zip and I can select Firefox, which is installed as well, as we can see. Firefox right over here. So if I go and say uninstall selection, what it will do is this will uninstall the following applications: 7-zip and Mozilla. Yes, I want to do so, and on the background it will start doing its thing and it will install the apps that we selected, which in this particular case were only two. And there we go, easy as this. We just removed two apps just by pressing this button, and I don't even need to go and select. The same we can do to install, and some of them I would suggest that you take a look at. If you don't know, just be aware that are utilities that are very useful. For example, for someone looking for codecs, which is something that sometimes we need to download for a machine to be able to read video formats or audio formats. And one of the things that we notice is when we search for codecs, we will find a lot of sites, and some of them are not legit. They have viruses and Trojans and whatnot. And right over here, you can just select the pack that you want, or several packs, install easy as that. So for example, if I want Keylight Codec Standard, I can select that. And if I want something from this one right over here, which I haven't used yet, 7-zip we have uninstalled, Firefox let me remove, and CPU-Z I've got right over here, GPU-Z as well. But if I want Crystal Disk, for example, and one thing that I don't want to forget as well, let's imagine that I do several installations per week on Windows 10 or Windows 11, and I've got 20 or 25 or 30 utilities or apps that I want to install on every single machine, I don't need to select each one. I can just select once and then create an export file with my configuration, and I just need to grab a USB drive, put that on the new machine that I just installed Windows, open up the tool and then import the file, and bam, install everything that I need with just one click. This is just awesome. So I just selected two apps, and if I press install or upgrade selected, what it will do basically is the same process as we did for the removal, which is it will install automatically. And there we go, just finished installing, and there is the desktop shortcut right over here for the Crystal Disk Info, but for the codecs it just installed, and that is it. We didn't need anything at all. So in my opinion, just great to install utilities like this, and we can remove them as well, as you could see. Now in terms of tweaks, it's also interesting because it has a few things that the WinPilot doesn't, so I do believe that this with WinPilot will be a great pack of tools that will take care probably of 95% of your issues with Windows 10 or 11. And for example, I can create a restore point in a really easy way. I will do here so that you can see. I can customize these things right over here, can enable the numlock on startup, and just small tweaks, but we can disable or enable the dark theme and so on. And here on the advanced tweaks, caution, because there are a few things that probably will not be cool. Remove all MES Store apps. Not recommended now. We don't need that. We don't need to be that radical. But let's say that I've got a laptop. If I press here, it will suggest things that I should do on my laptop. But one of the things besides all this, I want to create a restore point, which we will do. If I want minimal, it will just select the minimal. If I want desktop, it will create, select a few more. If I want to clear everything, it will clear. But let's put in laptop. Let's say that I want to use optimal performance and optimal settings for a laptop. I want to create a restore point just in case I want to go back. And if I press run tweaks, what it will do is on the background, we can see everything. It will start its job. And the first thing is creating a restore point, which is smart, isn't it? And then after the restore point, it will apply all the settings that we did select right over there, and we don't need to do anything else other than this. Easy as this. As you could see, it did do the restore point and it did apply all the settings that we selected. Just awesome. Now we also have a menu, which is the config menu, and we have a few things that are very useful right over here, and some things that might save our computer from things like if we have something broken with the Windows update, or if our network is not working and we want to reset, just a click of a button. Do you remember control panel? If I press right over here, it will, sorry, clicked twice, it will open the well-known control panel that we used a lot on Windows 10, but on Windows 11, although it's present, it's completely hidden. So if I want to use something on the control panel just because I want to, here it is. And who says that I want to use, I don't know, user accounts? This is an easy one to get there, but there we go. Here it is, the shortcut for that, and everything else that is right over here that looks really simple. Okay, I can go here, but how many seconds will I waste instead of clicking a button? And the same right over here, we can enable and disable some features. Now, for example, I don't have Hyper-V on this computer. I could enable, I could set setup auto login without passwords and so on and so forth on this computer. I can choose all these settings. Now on updates, there are three options, which I honestly agree with them. This is the default out of the box that it is right now. Security, we just be able to download the security updates and the others will be optional. And then here, we will disable all options. This might be useful in some case scenarios. Probably the computer is not connected to the internet, or if it's connected to the internet, it's not going to do anything that will risk our computer to get virus or anything else. So there are cases that this might be useful. If you're not sure, then you have these two settings. And then lastly, also really cool, which is the ability to create a micro Windows installer. Now, we have seen other solutions like Tiny 11, which I will try to leave the link down below, will help us to create a micro Windows 11 installation disk that we can install in machines that are not compatible with Windows 11 without prerequisites and all that stuff, without bloatware and completely safe, which is great. And basically right over here you will see, and you can read what it will do. It will download the Windows 11 image from Microsoft and so on, and it will put on the C drive, and it will this and it will that, and at the end you will have an installer with a clean installation of Windows that will be minimal in terms of software. So it might be useful as well, and I believe that it is. But for me, honestly, we have seen solutions for this that in my opinion are great, so I wouldn't use it just for this, but for installing apps and for tweaks and some configurations, I would say that probably one of the best that we have seen so far. And that being said, hope that the video was helpful. Hope that you enjoyed this tool along with WinPilot, which is great. And if you do, don't forget that usual thumbs up right over there, which is really appreciated on this side of the screen. If you feel that you want to share with us the opinion and what you use on your daily basis, feel free to do on the comment down below. My name is Roberto George, and as always, I'll see you on the next one.